Hello everybody, welcome to the first ever weekly Kubernetes moment. So, my name's Nigel Poulton. Those of you who know me, you know that I'm a couple of things. I'm a little bit over the top when it comes to passion, but the important thing is I am all about the tech. And these days, I am all about Kubernetes. Now, this is a new show that I'm bringing to you, and the clue is in the title. So we've got weekly, we'll be coming at you every week, and Kubernetes moment. So Kubernetes and just for a moment. So we're going for short and sharp, all right? Now then, what are the shows gonna look like? So anything really that's related to Kubernetes, we might have like a learning tip, we might have something that's going on, like an announcement or something that's in the news, or I don't know, maybe we'll just have an interview with somebody, maybe when we're at a show or something like that. Now, something a little bit special coming at the end, it's the Cricket World Cup at the moment, which I'm sure everybody knows. I got my mommy. So for the content this week, we're going to talk about Virtual Kubelet, and I'm going to give myself a bit of a challenge. So this right here is, I don't know, a fidget spinner, yeah? And I know that they're totally like last year or even the year before, right? But this one is outstanding for a couple of reasons. Number one, it kind of looks like the Kubernetes logo. Too many of these bits on the end here, but never mind. The other thing is, though, it is outstanding at spinning. So I think my record for this is 5 minutes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this going on the table and I'm going to describe Virtual Kubelet before it stops. It won't take 5 minutes, right? I'll beat the spinner. So here we go. So Virtual Kubelet. A lot of you will be thinking, okay, what the heck is that? Maybe you've heard of it, but you're not quite sure. So when we talk about a kubelet, really we're talking about a Kubernetes node. And what is a Kubernetes node? Well, it's a lot of things, but effectively it's a backend for Kubernetes that provides two things. So first up, it provides some networking, and second up, it provides a container runtime. So the runtime is what starts your pods and your containers, and it stops them and it manages the lifecycle. Generally speaking, a Kubernetes node is a virtual machine, okay? And it runs the kubelet, it will run something like Docker or containerd as the container runtime, so something to start and stop the containers, and then it runs kubeproxy to do the networking. Now, the idea behind Virtual Kubelet is, well, if a node is just a backend providing those two things, does it have to be a virtual machine? And the answer is no, of course it doesn't. So what if my cloud, let's say Microsoft Azure, was to provide a backend that spun up containers and provided networking? Hello, ACI, if you know Microsoft Azure. So the idea is instead of having a virtual machine that provides this backend for your containers and your pods to run on, let's just farm that out to our cloud provider and let them provide it. So instead of having a Kubernetes cluster that has 10, 15, 20 virtual machines all joined as nodes, you can have Virtual Kubelet join ACI, and ACI is a cloud backend, right? Which has effectively infinite capacity. You can spin up as many containers or pods as you want on ACI. It provides the networking and you've got access to an infinite pool of, I guess, nodes. Now, if it's a little bit hard to get your head around, maybe think about it like this. We already have managed Kubernetes, so Azure Kubernetes Service, Elastic Kubernetes Service from AWS, and Google Kubernetes Engine from the Google Cloud. And they manage the control aspects of a Kubernetes cluster. So we already say to our cloud providers, in some instances, right, take care of the control plane side of Kubernetes for us. So maybe think of Virtual Kubelet as a way of saying to our cloud, now I'm not saying it's exactly the same, right? But of saying to our cloud provider, take care of all of this kind of node madness for us. We don't want to have to care about the control plane anymore. You manage it for us. And while we're on, we don't even really want to care about the nodes either. So take care of our nodes for us. So that's Virtual Kubelet. Oh, and I'm beating this fidget spinner there. So Virtual Kubelet, you don't have to have physical nodes or virtual machines as your nodes anymore. You can just have a cloud backend that will run containers for you and provide networking. Now, of course, yeah, there are limitations and challenges and it's all pretty new, but I tell you what, it is exciting stuff. Now, the one thing that makes me a little bit sad, right, is anybody that knows me, I think, like I said, knows that I am all about the tech. So letting my cloud provider manage the control plane for me, I get like the business advantages for that. But for me as a techie, I'm a little bit sad because I actually want to know and understand the control plane and I want to own it and I want to manage it. And I'm kind of the same with the nodes. So I've got this internal battle going on that I love the tech behind the nodes and the kubelet and the container runtime and all of that. And I want to own it and manage it. But I get the simplicity of just letting my cloud provider do it. So I've got a balance there that Virtual Kubelet is a super cool project and I love the tech behind it, but in a way it's almost stealing the tech from me. So if I've got a Kubernetes cluster with a managed control plane and then Virtual Kubelet's going on, what have I as a techie got left to do? And from a business perspective, sometimes that can be a really good thing. I get that. And I beat the spinner. Come on! So, with it being the Cricket World Cup, and cricket being the official game of Kubernetes, I'm just kidding about that, but it should be, thought I'd go for something a little bit special here. So Ash is going to bowl, and I'm going to hit for a four, I think. Let's go for this. Oh, no. Slip dropped it. Oh, four. Yeah.